Hello, David. It's Robert here again. Just wanted to chat with you a little bit about what happened to me today. I was at a prayer meeting with a group from my church, and we were praying about what was going on in our world today. And one of the brothers came forward, and he had a really interesting analogy that I'd like to share with you. And it's along this lines. He was talking about Jesus and the man who was at the pool at Bethesda, the lame man. And he equated the church situation, the church in Canada, to like that lame man. You see, the lame man does not have the ability to go and make it in time whenever the angel comes and stirs the water. And that lame man literally needed Jesus to come along and help him out of that situation. And he equated the church being like that lame man. We know that God can do all things, but in our mindset, we already been defeated because the simple fact is we feel we can't move fast enough. We're not strong enough to go and get our victory when the Lord stirs the waters. And that's why we need Jesus to come and help us. That's why we need the Lord to enable us to be able to see beyond what we're able to see. You see, like that lame man, we only see the difficulty. We only see the problems. We don't see the solution. We don't see the victory. And so my prayer for us today, David, is this, that we would begin to see beyond the pool and we'd see that there's someone coming our way. There's someone going to help us, and that is the Lord Himself. Revival, I suppose, is recognizing that we need God's help. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, "If my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray, seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then the Lord promises he will hear from heaven, forgive our sins, and heal our land." Our problem is we need to begin to understand and see things the way that God sees them. We need to see that God sees the victory. We don't. But we need to trust God that He's going to bring the victory in His due season. When we least expect, the Lord is going to come along. He's going to open our vision. And in that moment, we have to say, "Yes, Lord, I am going to trust you. Even though I don't see what's going on right now, I'm going to trust you because I know a victory is coming." And that's how I kind of want to, when I come to prayer, I don't want to have the lame man's vision where all I see is the problems. All I see is the seeing off to the side there, God is moving and saying, "Well, God can do that for somebody else, but He can't do it for me." What we all need to do, David, is we need to see with the vision of God. We need to see what God sees. We need to know what God knows. And the way that we can do that, David, is through prayer and through Bible reading. You know, Isaiah 40:31 says, "They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint." God has made a promise that we will soar among the eagles one day. But first of all, we have to wait. We have to wait for the Lord's timing. We have to wait with expectation. We have to wait with the vision to see things and ready to go when God calls us and when God does it. And I think that if we do that, David, we're going to see a lot more victories than we currently see. My prayer is that the Lord will open our eyes to that very fact. Thank you for spending some time with me, David. God bless.